Howdy. I'm anti-fascist cowboy Rex Hooper. One of the things I love about Western movies, as well as many other genres, is that they could hide a political message within a compelling story. And Westerns are very political. More than almost any other movie, it's the Westerns that seem to reflect the political landscape of the time that they were made. And one great example of such, and a great movie, is The Oxbow Incident.
This truck's running off the road, tampered with the brakes. When it comes to money, do the takes.
The Oxbow Incident is a 1943 movie starring Henry Fonda, directed by William Wellman. It is a very political movie, but the real joy of it is that the politics are buried within a very compelling story. The story is about two drifting cowpokes coming into the town of Oxbow and finding out that there's been a murder. And the people of Oxbow decide to take justice in their own hands. The sheriff isn't present, so they form an illegal posse to try and track down the murderers. What ensues is a story about mob mentality, about what happens when folks start going along with the crowd rather than thinking for themselves. It also is a message about justice itself. Now, many Westerns deal with the aspect of justice and the frontier justice, the Wild West justice, but what the Oxbow Incident does is makes it relevant for whichever time or place you happen to be watching this movie. It was made in 1943, but still, the message of the justice and the justice system is very much relevant today. The bigger political message of the Oxbow Incident is, I believe, that it's an allegory for fascism and the rise of fascism that was taking place in Europe at the time. At the time of the making and release of the Oxbow Incident, World War II was in full swing, and the Allied forces were fighting against the fascist Nazis of Germany. One of the primary themes of the Oxbow Incident is that of justice. The mob believes that they are just in forming this posse and taking down these killers, but it is that same mob mentality, that same sense of justice that can lead to violent fascist tendencies. And it's how, in the name of justice, atrocities can be committed. The posse acts without regard for the law or due process. They have a tendency towards violence. They're trigger happy. One of the things that the Oxbow Incident does incredibly well is it captures some of that essence of the human condition. This is the power of cinema and of story, is that they're able to reflect back on us certain aspects of ourselves that maybe we wouldn't have seen otherwise. Part of that human condition is that none of the characters, none of the folks that form the posse, these residents of the town of Oxbow, they're not bad people, not necessarily. Complex characters, sure. They're all coming at it from their own angles and their own experiences. But not bad people. Just ordinary folks, like you and me. And just like you and me, and any other ordinary folks, you can be coerced and manipulated. Why? Well, because part of that mob mentality is serving one higher goal, one purpose. That is exciting. And the excitement of the crowd, the excitement of catching criminals and bringing them to justice, can lead you into maybe not questioning everything you should, maybe not looking too deeply into the evidence on show, not giving due process to the justice system. In this way, the movie can be seen as an allegory for the fascist movement, and as to how fascism can manipulate people, their emotions and their desires, and use them to act out dangerous and violent crimes. The film's message is timeless and relevant today. It reminds us to stay vigilant in upholding the rule of law and fighting against extremist movements that threaten our justice, our democracy, and our human rights. You got to go.
before you got to stand before your maker. You got to stand there by yourself. Nobody here can stand for you. You got to stand there by yourself. Oh, you got to.
Henry Fonda stars in this movie and is spectacular as always. He's an incredible actor, and he gives an incredible performance in this movie. Part of what makes his performance so incredible, I believe, is the fact that it was a personal movie for him as well. When Henry Fonda was but 14 years old, in the year 1919, he witnessed the lynching of a man. When he was just a boy, he saw how a community could make a show out of the execution of a man. And seeing that atrocity affected him for the rest of his life. The final monologue that Henry Fonda gives, I believe the power of his performance is because part of that monologue explains how he felt most of his life about what he saw at age 14. Well, there you have it, folks. That's my take on the Oxbow Incident, one of my all-time favorite movies. It's a very political movie, like I said, but is there any other political westerns that you enjoy? What is the deeper message behind The Outlaw Josie Wales or The Searchers or, heck, even Rio Bravo? Does it have a political message? Let me know in the comments section below. All the comments, they all help me out, so engage with the community. Abandon any reservations you have about typing something and type something. Go on, go for it. Give me even just a recommendation for a Western that you like. Also, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, that helps me out. And if you're a fan of Westerns and looking for more Western content, then I would appreciate it if you check out my record, Frontera USA, available on Bandcamp, on the Spotify, and wherever else you listen to music. Alright, cowpokes. Stay vigilant. And I'll see you later on down the trail.